Yes, I do remember. I remember feeling emotional, of course, the day that they were coming out. But not only just because of them, but because I knew that many millions of people like me were watching television with one idea in their minds, which is the supreme value of life. And that, in our times in which we are used to watch television and see so much violence and how depreciated life has been, suddenly became very important that everybody was in the same note at the same time, watching these guys coming out of the mine, because in a way, we were all coming out of the mine. Yeah, right at that point, actually, I thought, ooh, somebody's gonna make a movie out of this. And then someday, they call me, Mike called me, and he says, I would like to have a meeting with you and a woman called Patricia Reagan, and she's the director, and we would like to talk to you about this, the possibility of making this movie, you know. And at the beginning, I thought probably what anybody would have thought. You know, we know the beginning, we know the end of the movie, you know, how. But then you start discovering that there were many things that were happening down there. And you see this kind of light female forces outside of the mine digging down. And you see these male, dark guys, masculine, inside digging out. And then you start seeing things, you know. You know, you start understanding that the movie was actually, you know, an ode to life itself. And to reflect about that was very interesting. Oh yes, we were together for many days, and we spent a lot of time together. He is a survivor since very early ages, you know, since he was a kid, a little kid. Learned to survive, that was the only way for him to keep going. And so life gave him finally an opportunity to actually pay off all his life of sacrifices, you know, between him and his family, his father, his brothers, and just give life to the guy. He knew how to distribute time. He knew how to spend time. And he knew that time was the key factor in there. You know, I mean, the difficulties for the guys outside to find them, it was enormous. You know, those drills bending all time in the way down, it was very difficult that they actually could take them out alive. But he's an example of faith, basically. Faith, when you believe in the things that you don't even know that are there. I suppose that, yes. In situations like this, there is something inside of us that becomes alive. And it's very unexpected. You probably don't even know that you have. I have seen that. I have seen that traveling, for example, with UNICEF in war situations. I was in Somalia in a war situation, and I saw that in the eyes of many people that I met there, invisible heroes, people that work with international organizations, soldiers for, you know, peace missions for United Nations, stuff like that. I've seen that type of, you know, drive. And many people actually get used to that, and they cannot live in normal societies. They have to go back to that kind of situation in order to feel life. What these guys live in those 70 days is incredible for them.